I take the challenge now of going smaller when you have to do a tiny branch that requires one bristle of paint. And my palette for cleaning off becomes my fingernail. Because you're up so close and you've got such details, at first it just looks like it's really fuzzy or muddy. And you pull away and you're like, that's a tiny little valley with a tiny little sailboat in the distance on a lake. People say, oh my God, that's a painting, are you sure? And I was like, yeah.
Lisa Rogers' love for art and her intuitive sense that accessories are important started young.
I got in trouble at the age of 3 by drawing on my mom's white brocade couch with pen outlining the flowers because I thought they'd look better, did show up better.
She never studied art and was never formally trained. She spends her days working as a vice president for a manufacturing company. But her nights and weekends are spent here in her Hampton Falls studio.
It feeds my art soul. It really does. And because art has always been such a huge part of my life. And it makes me feel something inside that nothing else does.
Her life as a miniature painter started with a simple purchase.
I was at an antique shop and bought this cool brooch, and it was antique, filigree. And I thought, oh, that would be kind of neat, because I do like accessories. And the middle cabochon fell out. And I was like, oh. Well, I looked at it and I said, So I took out, I have special canvas paper, and I started painting on it and popped it in and put it on my Facebook page, and it blew up.
Since then, she's used tiny daubs of paint and itty-bitty brushes to make a big impact.
I love all things nautical. My husband and I used to sail a lot when we lived out in Seattle. So I've incorporated, I like those so much that I painted this one. And this is an upcycled piece too that I found in an antique shop. I've been influenced by various artists in the past, particularly the Hudson Valley painters, their landscapes. I've always had been a large admirer of those. I'm not too rigid in my design. I kind of let the inspiration be from the underlying piece.
Lisa jokes that the materials are cheap. It takes her years to get through one tube of paint.
7 millimeters is my smallest. I've got a little pair of earrings over there. I think these are about 10 millimeters. And I have really simple stuff. There's the old adage, why buy it when you can make it with $92 worth of craft supplies? Yeah, I'm that girl.
And if you think 2020 vision is a job requirement, think again.
I'm blind as a bat. I wear contacts and readers, and I have a magnifying glass. So I have all the accoutrements to make this happen. These here are tiny little seascapes with dune grass with an Osmina pearl. A large part of what I do is upcycling. I love going to flea markets and antique shops and finding unique pieces. And sometimes the planning starts right there as I'm holding it. They connect first with what they see inside, which is my hope. And it's kind of a sometimes tricky thing when I'm designing. Because sometimes I'm afraid maybe the exterior piece that's going to house it is going to detract from the painting. I do like things that bling, so I'm attracted to a little bit of sparkle, so I'll add that to it with different gemstones or something that kind of takes it in a little edge. I want people to notice the painting itself, but maybe the way it glimmers in the light or something like that.
Lisa's work doesn't end with jewelry, and it isn't all micro-sized.
I'm like a pinball machine. I'm all over the place. I see something, I gotta paint it. So that's my 3-year-old coming back out in me again. I take classic paintings and put them right on the back. I want a kind of a showstopper piece. You know, it looks like a regular denim jacket from the front, but when you turn around or you're from behind, you get something completely unique.
She also paints shoes and pants, just about anything she can jazz up with a little color.
For me, I've seen necessity is the mother of invention. As I've gotten older, I've looked and I'm not really thrilled by what I see out there. So I design it, I'll make it, I'll create it.
Lisa has often sold her work right off her own ears, neck, and back. She has never felt like her art belongs on a wall.
Enjoy the art, wear it, kind of be a curator in a different sense of your art, you know, collect it. I like it that when people go out and they say, oh my God, I wore these and I had so many compliments. People zoom in, you know, so if you don't mind people zooming into you so close to take a look, you know, because not everybody is super comfortable with that. but you know what, it is a unique thing that makes people pause a little bit, you know, so you're a walking little showcase of art. If my work can make someone feel better by wearing it, I think I'm pretty blessed to have that. This is my passion. This is me, and I can't tell you enough, go for what makes you happy.